Hi everyone, Dordekitty here. On my channel, you will often see lots of buildings and complex roads and junctions with cars running on them. However, when you go to the same location in your copy of FlightGear, you'll likely see a barren landscape with grey roads and no buildings, even though you turn on automatic scenery download. What gives? Simple, I have installed many scenery packs. Oh, by the way, Dordekitty now has a Ko-fi page. The page is currently dedicated to helping hospitals in my country get through COVID-19 and can be found at ko-fi.com/dordekitty. First up, we have to find some scenery to download. A quick web search for your favorite airport will bring it up. I'm gonna download this one. You can also look on the scenery section of the FlightGear forum, where scenery creators post their work. One of the must-haves is Project 3000, which adds automatically generated airport buildings to most airports. They look very generic, but it's better than nothing. There's also a worldwide OSM2 CD scenery effort, but right now it's kind of cumbersome to download, so I'll skip over it. You get the scenery as a zip file, extract it anywhere you want. You can't extract scenery packs over each other. If they don't cover the same area, nothing will be overwritten. Now, start up FlightGear, go to the Add-ons tab, then add your new folder to the Additional Scenery Folders section. You can click on these arrows to rearrange the priority of each pack. Due to technical limitations, you must put scenery packs with terrain at the bottom. If you find yourself in an ocean even after manually installing scenery, this might be why. If there's a README file inside the folder, open it and follow the instructions inside. Some scenery packs will not work if you haven't followed those instructions. Now you're ready to fly. Don't forget to turn on buildings and roads if you want to see them. And enjoy! Thanks for watching Dordekitty. Things are getting busier on my side, so I'm sorry if the video quality dropped. Safe flights!